As said by everyone, even I am very pleased to be here and be a part of this Golden Jubilee celebration. All the more because I happen to be a past student of this institute, and this is here where I found my life partner too. Is that right, Pradeep? After a long sessions on architecture and interiors, I feel I'm going to quickly, in inverted commas, run through a few visuals of outdoor spaces designed by our office. I'm going to start with smaller spaces, as I usually do for my presentations, like rooftop gardens. This is a residential terrace in North Mumbai. That's the plan. I'm really going to be fast. This is how it looks. Basically, the softscapes are at the exteriors because load and drainage is a great concern on top of the buildings, on the terraces. This is again another terrace in a very old building, bang on Chowpatty. I hope this runs well. Again, lot of hardscapes, being an old building, and spaces like these were created where I could possibly, you know, make these kind of seatings. I had to raise the area for lawns. Basically, there were two parts of terraces on this project because of the staircase block in between. One became the private terrace and the other for the public. That's the Malabar Hill on the left side, which gets translated into softscapes onto the terrace. That's how it looks at night. This is an office terrace, a corporate office for Sterlite Industries in a heritage building near Gateway of India. There were materials which were used inside. I tried to get it out so that it was a continuous process. There were ugly looking ducts which I was not allowed to touch, but inspired by Louis Barragan's architecture, I created these niches to just conceal the dirty looking ducts. Basically, this is an Art Nouveau building. Try to get the motifs onto the landscape too. This is how one sees Gateway of India from this terrace. This is a commercial terrace for Maker Chamber 4. It's on 14th floor. That's the plan. It is let out for inmates for get-togethers. And that's how this came up, with a lot of hard surface. And at the periphery, which you see the softscapes, there were a whole lot of service pipes running all along the parapet wall, which I tried to conceal by giving greenery. At the same time, avoiding people to go near the parapet after a few drinks. That was the stage for dancing with a built-in seat. A lot of color I tried to put in onto the basic gray flooring by way of mosaic work. That's the entrance you see to the terrace. This is a podium garden designed for K. Rahejas in Raheja, Bihar. Due to lot of requirement of car parking, one is left out with these podiums as lungs to be designed for high-rise residential complexes. I love to use wood in my works because it gives a lot of warmth, and being in tropics, wood is the material which really goes well. That's a sunken dance floor. These are the walkways. as a children's play area onto the podium itself. This is a specialty restaurant within a club called Ozone Club in Goregaon. It's the outdoor space of the specialty restaurant, which serves Mediterranean cuisine, and therefore the theme was white and blue. Again, a very tight space between the built form and the boundary. So this paving which you see, the blue mosaic which runs all along the length of the internal space between the built form and the boundary wall. Basically to give a Mediterranean feel. That's the main restaurant. There's a sit-out space, waiting area. Now I'm moving on to some few private houses which I have done. This is in Jalgaon. The architect had used a lot of red agra onto the plinth, which I transferred onto my landscape elements, but in a different texture of kapchi work. This is a beach house bang on the sea at Kihim. The plinth was so low, it just then unfolded into the landscape. And this is the main area. This was the main area where a lot of congregation took place. The client plays a lot of cricket. That's why the half acre which you see is left completely as a thick blade lawn for him to play cricket on. I'm really happy to say that not a single tree was cut on this site. There were a lot of existing palm trees. And this pathway which you see, my husband had used a lot of Shahabad inside the house to give a weekend house or a farmhouse effect. With the wastage, I have used it outside onto the pathways. This is what you see, and one tried to protect these trees. There were a lot of constraints of plant material being just 500 meters away from the sea. This is a view from the house. This is another project which we just completed in Alibaug. This, the best part of this house was it was very transparent. So minimal landscape was thought of and maximum natural landscape was gotten. And this building was placed, I would say, respecting the existing trees. Nearly 100 years old existing wood trees are there on this site, which you see at that backdrop. And the whole view is towards the natural landscape. Ages back, I completed this World Trade Center project. It was more on forms, so that the neighboring skyscrapers also could enjoy this landscape. And this waterfall happens on the axis of the shopping outlet. This is how the formation of the plants were envisaged. This is a project in Thane. Voltas India Limited are the clients, and in highly polluted area this was placed. These used to be kennel houses during British era, which the architect converted into small rooms, spacious good rooms for trainees to stay in. It is attached to the HRD center. It was more of an inward looking space, quite sunken inside. So it was more of a fringe of hardscape and softscapes in between. This was a multi-purpose stage where they could lay their table or performs in, they could get together or perform in the evenings. This is an IT park which, for best reason, the brief was no big trees. The reason all of us know, and that's how this evolved.